check this one out. I think that's the most defined I've seen of the two fronts meeting each other. Okay, so for separate. See, Trade Post Liquor, that is actually a trade name. Two different trade names at one location. And Beth's place used to be right there. So that implies they bought out the trade name. Secretary of State's website, one of the divisions, is trade name registration. Okay, so coming over to the business tab, he's got a search for the database, and I haven't even looked at it yet. Yeah, I spent a little bit in jail, so by the time I noticed it, she was closed. 422 Supreme Fancy LLC. So that's not the business location. So in theory, that would be the home office. That's filing. Trying to get back to that. It's unusual to go to an S corporation and drop down like that. Definitely something fishy going on. Okay, I came back, basically gave up, but I come back just to check one more. Looking at basically D is dissolved. So the expiration date, or which would have been renewal if they change your mind in theory. So it's dissolved there, but somehow I guess it would be like a cell phone number. You got recycled in the system. But see, 2016 would not get recycled. Okay, so that was the last one. So that was the update of the end of the business, and then somehow a 2018 S Corporation. In the same year. On the expiration date. Look at that again. 9-1. Yeah, 9-1. So a person would have had to reserve that in advance. It don't make sense on the same day, but there's probably not legislation stating a 24-hour like clearance house gap. But yeah, it strikes me fishy, all the additional changes, and it doesn't even reference to that location. So yeah, I'd definitely take some research for sure. But that address is nowhere associated with it. So yeah, it definitely seems like some kind of circulatory fraud. But now that kind of sucks. I get hot water from them. And actually, when I was getting hot water, I turned around and looked, and I seen they had something, I guess, kind of similar, a knockoff. I don't know how close the name was to actually ramen. Anyway, so for like $3.99, looks like they had a bag with four of them in it. Shipping costs probably got to be pretty high. They were fairly moist and fairly heavy, so. Anyway, I usually only do one. These bags aren't really too trustworthy, but usually it's broken up more than that. I'll put them down there and let them heat up, basically. And then I had a huge craving for some vegetables. I didn't even see the asparagus in it, but tasted fresh asparagus and it actually was a lot better than cooked. So I just mixed it up with the hot sauce that I've got. Some cheese in there, some vegetables, and for less than $4, like three times that amount.